Hey, what's up everyone? NeoCypher here with another Pokemon card opening video. This one a little different, and I wouldn't be surprised if you've never seen anything like this. So, long story short, last night I had to run out to Walmart to buy me a new iron, because the iron I currently had to finish making this started to... Well, it wasn't putting out that much heat, even on the highest setting, so I figured it's on its way out. I had to run out and get a new iron, and Walmart had... where there was the closest store with one relatively cheap in price. It did the job, but while I was there, I looked for a couple card things I don't already have. Not like the new ones from like a Rise of the Guardians, whatever it's called. But like the Zapdos pin set and the Solgaleo Alola box. They didn't have those, but they had this, which kind of piqued my interest. It's a mystery power box that has 5 random boosters as well as a... little freebie item, like a little bonus item. Sounds like a keychain, maybe. I don't know. But what intrigued me, though, is that there's apparently a 1 in 20 chance to get a legacy booster pack, meaning something from, like, some of the original sets. Apparently, EX Holland Phantoms, I guess, is a legacy pack now. I'm guessing anything that's not, like, X and Y, or maybe even a black and white. So... I'm going to open this up here. This, I didn't know how much it was until I got to the self-checkout, because there was no price tag with it. It was about $25, which equates to about $5 per booster pack, which is quite a bit. And you could argue, well, I'm just going to open this off camera. You could argue that the pin sets are the same thing. They're about $15, or that's $5 per pack. But at least the pins there are actually pretty good. I don't know what the free item is in this thing. So for all I know, it could be... like I said, a keychain. So let's see what's going to open up here. I'm going to slow roll everyone on the pack, so I do want to get to the item first, see what it is. Item is a coin. A chessman coin. But a coin. Okay, so let's go ahead and see what the 5 packs we have are. It actually does, I'm not going to show the code, it actually comes with a code card to unlock a deck online. It's interesting, I'll just check that deck out. So we have, let's see, the packs we have are EX Roaring Skies, Evolutions, Holland Phantoms, Phantom Forces, and the fifth one's actually attached on the front here. I almost thought I got gypped the pack. I can't pull it out. There we go. And the fifth and final pack is Phantom Forces. So they're all X and Y packs, which is actually pretty good. These might be for sets I don't have yet, actually. Well, Evolutions I do have, obviously, but Phantom Forces and Roaring Skies I may not have. I mean, pull up real quick here. There is an app I've been using on my phone to keep track of my card collections called Pokecard X, Pokecard EX, however you want to pronounce it. And no, these videos aren't sponsored by them or anything like that, but it's actually a pretty interesting little app here. Just show it off real quick. I can keep track of all my cards from the different sets. The website itself, I believe, is, I can't remember what the actual language is. The app itself is in full English, but if you download card scans, it's in a different language, just as a warning. Just because of the people who made it, their native language, etc. Point is, though, I can briefly look and see if I've got anything from Phantom Forces or Roaring Skies. No, I don't have anything from either, so I'm going to open those two packs, or those 4 packs, last start with Evolutions, because I don't have anything from either of these two sets. So, we're going to start off with Evolutions, where I have, well, a good amount of cards from Evolutions. So, do I have to say, is this worth $25? Probably not. Now, if I were to have gotten a... quote-unquote legacy pack, maybe. But as is, I wouldn't necessarily say this is worth the $20 or $25. So, for Evolutions, we have Brock's Grit. Maintenance. That was a fun card when it first came out. Switch. Sandshrew. Onix. Kurp. Fighting Energy. Staryu. Reverse Holo for the pack is a Magnemite, which I'm pretty sure I've already got the Reverse Holo Magnemite. And the final card for the Evolutions pack is... Alright, a holographic Machamp. But no, this is the only holographic Machamp I have that looks like this without the first edition symbol. If you don't know what I'm referring to, the Machamp from the original base set only came in first edition because it only came in the starter kits, or starter sets. You couldn't actually get it individually. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and go with Roaring Skies next. I don't know much about either. They're all, Roaring Skies and Phantom Forces are both XY sets, so... Nothing from Black and White or Diamond and Pearl or anything like that. It would be funny if I got an EX pack, because EX is around where I stopped, where I initially stopped collecting years ago. Alright, so... Okay, I'm sorry, I'm losing my mind. For a minute, I went to, I did the card trick, I did this, thinking, wait, is there a card that's actually upside down? No, I'm an idiot. I was holding it upside down. So anyways, we have a Fearow, Unpheasant, or Unpheasant, Electrode, Natu, a Natu Delta, I think it's Delta, or whatever that technically is considered. I can never remember what that's technically called. Omega, maybe. That maybe it's Delta Plus. I can't tell. I don't know my symbols. Togepi, Fletchling, Execute. Reverse Holo for the pack is a not too Delta, I guess. Again, I'm going to criticize for these symbols. I can't remember what they're called. And the final card for this pack, a Mega Latios EX for my first ever Roaring Skies pack. That is really nice. And again, I'm easily entertained. So not bad. So far we've got a holographic Machamp out of Evolutions, a Mega Latios EX, not quite full art, out of the first Roaring Skies pack. So maybe this particular box was worth $25 in terms of card value, or at least getting there, but... Hi. So the other Roaring Skies pack, we have a Manectric, Trainer's Mail, Pelipper, Spearow, Wingull, Binacle, Pikachu, Inkay. Reverse Holo for the pack is a Zapdos, very nice. And the final card for this pack is, wow, a Holographic Jirachi. You know, I've got to say that for the, my first two Roaring Skies packs, those are actually pretty good. Let's see if Phantom Forces can match that or do any better. So it's not bad that so far, three packs, I've gotten a EX and two holographic rares. Not to mention, I got a rare holographic rare for the Zapdos. All right. So, for my first Phantom Forces pack, we have Robo Substitute, Versus Seeker, Boldore, Spearow, Gulpin, Totodile, Yanma, Litwick. Reverse Holo for the pack is a Gligar, and the final card for this pack is a Honchkrow. I see a lot of Murkrows in Pokemon Go, and I've got probably close to enough candy to ever evolve into a Honchkrow if Honchkrow ever comes to the game. I can't remember, though, what generation Honchkrow is right off the top of my head. So I'm wanting to say it's at least Generation 4, but again, usually once I get past Generation 2, I kind of start to get a little fuzzy as to what generations of what Pokemon are from. And now, the second Phantom Forces pack. We have Boldore, wow, two Phantom Forces packs, and I've already got a freaking uncommon duplicate. Kingler, Double Colorless Energy, Fletchling, Muna, Bronzor, Purloin, Sewaddle. Reverse Holo for the pack is a Gourgeist. Never came across that, though I've never actually evolved a Pumpkaboo. And the final card for this video is a Gliscor. That Gligar I just got. So, overall, not bad. I mean, the first three packs really It did well for me with the holographic Machamp. Nice little throwback to the days of yore. The Mega Latios EX and the Jirachi. So, don't expect to see these boxes on video, if at all, again. Because, yeah, again, you can liken it to the Trainer or the Legendary Beast pin sets where you have 5 packs. They average out to about $5 a piece, but at least with the pin sets, you have 3 packs that still measured about $5 each, but at least with the pin sets, you get a nice pin. Here, right, chest pin coin. And don't get me wrong, it looks nice. And if I was fully collecting Pokemon coins, it'd be nice to add to the collection, but I'm not. I just get them as they come to me. So that's really all I've got for this video. I thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.